Hi, my name is Bonnie Lipke. I am one of the nurses that works here at Bellin College in the HSRC. HSRC stands for the Health Science Resource Center. This is kind of an important part of the learning here because this is where the hands-on stuff happens, where you learn to do actual skills. I'd like to introduce the rest of the HSRC team. First, we have Kevin Stringer. Kevin Stringer is our technology coordinator.
Hi, my name is Kevin Stringer. I'm the technology coordinator down here in the HSRC. When you come down here, you'll see me running around fixing mannequins, turning mannequins on, also working with all the electronics that you guys will utilize during your time down here.
Hi, I'm Sarah Johnson. I'm one of the HSRC coordinators down here along with Bruce. And I also help with setting up with simulations, help you practicing your hands-on skills. I have also been a registered nurse for 24 years, and my experience includes short stay, outpatient endoscopy, pulmonary, and orthopedics and neurology. So welcome, and if you have any questions with anything, feel free to seek us out.
Hi, my name is Bruce Chenin. I'm also one of the HSRC lab coordinators. I've been a registered nurse for 15 years. I have prior experience in CVICU, telemetry, med-surg, progressive care unit, case management, hospice. I've been a nursing instructor as well as a nurse aid instructor, and I am here to assist with any of your learning needs.
Hi, we moved on to one of our health assessment rooms. This room has seven exam tables, and this is the first hands-on class you're going to have, learning how to assess a patient. Heart sounds, lung sounds, things like that. So we're just giving you a view of the room here. We actually have one of our faculty with us today. This is Kathy Demuth. And the students are practicing for their skills portion of their testings. Now we're in our simulation lab, and our patient today is Timothy. We've named all our mannequins down here. Just kind of helps us know where we're going and who we're gonna get ready for simulation. Timothy is our newest mannequin that we have. We just got him, and he is a five-year-old. What is really cool about Timothy is he can have facial expressions, he can yawn, he can track you, so his head will turn and follow you around the bed. We can do a blood pressure on him, listen to heart and lung sounds. His hands are nice and movable. He has pupil dilation and constriction. He has pulses everywhere a person would have a pulse. And if I didn't say it, heart sounds, lung sounds, bowel sounds. And then we have a controller in our control room behind us, and we're able to talk for Timothy and interact with the students so they can have hands-on experience with a patient before they actually get to the hospital. Okay, now we're in our birthing suite, and this is Victoria. As you can see, Victoria is rather pregnant. Just actually about an hour and a half ago, Victoria gave birth to five babies. So we're able to put a baby in her stomach and actually deliver it. It's really great practice for the students. She also opens her eyes, she talks, she has heart sounds, lung sounds, pulses everywhere a person has a pulse. So it's a really great experience for the students to learn what to do when they're in the middle of a delivery. This is Mike. Mike is our most sophisticated mannequin that we have here. He can do the most stuff. So as you see, we have some supplies in the bed here with him. He can be intubated. He can cry. He sweats. He froths at the mouth. His water will come out of his ears. He has a pulse everywhere. A person will have a pulse, so in the neck, arms. There's a brachial one up here. He also has femoral and pedal pulses in the feet. He has heart sounds, lung sounds, bowel sounds. He can be get a catheter, or he can void to get urine out of him. He can bleed also. So if that is required in the simulation, you can do that too. We spend a lot of time in here, and like I said earlier with Timothy, it gives us time to let the students practice, have some hands-on experience, know how to use the equipment before they actually get in the room. The students really enjoy it. We do quite a few simulations. Every class seems to have a couple at least, and we do have a full simulation course also. Now we are in our surgery room or operating room. This mannequin that we have on our operating table is Damaged Debbie. Damaged Debbie has 3 gunshot wounds in her chest and abdomen. And what's cool about that is there's some real bullets in there. So our sonography students, our radiology students will come down here and they'll practice locating those bullets with x-ray. We use this room a lot to get the students to understand what they can touch, what they can't touch, what's sterile, not sterile, and making sure that they know how to put on the proper protection, the hat, the mask, booties, gloves, everything. So when they get to clinical at the hospital and they're going into the operating room, they can feel comfortable walking in and knowing what they can and can't do. And if you have any questions, please let any of the Bellin College faculty, students, representatives know.